So in the last session, what we did, we enabled currency by following this navigation, set up currencies, define, and after taking the navigation, we have to find our currency and we have to enable the checkbox. And we created primer ledger by following this navigation, set up financials, accounting setup manager, ASM, accounting setups. By using this navigation, we created primary ledger. How to create the primary ledger? If you are going to face this question, how you can answer? So now my question is, how to create the primary ledger? Anyone, please. We created primary ledger. Now you can answer. I want to see how you are going to answer.
By giving primary ledger name and by selecting the chart of account structure, accounting calendar and currency and accounting method, we can create the primary ledger.
Yeah, so exactly what process we followed to create the primary ledger, the same points we have to explain. How to create the primary ledger means first we have to provide the primary ledger name. We have to select calendar, currency, chart of accounts and accounting method. So this is what we have to answer for that sort of questions. What is the navigation to create the primary ledger that you no need to include within that answer, because the point is very clear. The question related to navigation or creation, definition. So question related to how to create that you have to explain. You no need to include any navigation. What is the navigation to create the primary ledger? That we know very well. Set up financials, accounting setup manager and accounting setup. Okay, so you have to be very clear on the questions also. Okay, navigation is different and definition is different. Exactly, we should catch that point to answer the relevant questions. Fine. So we created primary ledger. After creating the primary ledger, we enabled allow dynamic inserts at chart of accounts level. Without enabling, we cannot create any code combinations. Okay, without enabling allow dynamic inserts, we cannot create any code combination. Why code combinations are required? Say for example, I want to create the transaction. If I want to create the transaction, I have to select the company and we have to select department the transactions belongs to, which department and which account we have to select. For company, we have company values, department values, for account values. So for every value, we given the number. Say company 1000. Say we have many values, right? I'm just taking one value, company. So the transaction we are going to create with the company called as 1000. What is the meaning of 1000? We know already we given within our chart of account structure. And department is 1000. Account may be 2000. Maybe say that is 2000 is expense account. It could be any account, but just for our understanding. So company is 1000. 1000 means we have a description for that within our value set. And department 1000 we given as a finance department. 2000 think that is expense account. So this is how we have a segment values. Now if you want to record the transactions, instead of taking the exact names for those segment values, simply you can select the code. For company code 1000. 1000 got some meaning, right? So we given Apple Computers. Company name is Apple Computers. So again, department instead of taking finance, simply you can select the code. 1000 means department. And say expense account or say salaries account. That is 2000. This is how you can take. So company is one code, department is one code, and account is one code. So multiple codes we are combining. Multiple codes we are combining and we are separating with some symbol. You can take anything here. I taken the dot. Okay, multiple codes we are combining. That is reason that we call as, which we are combining, codes we are combining, so that we call as code combination. Code combination, CC. If you are going to create any transaction, this is how we have to select. This is how you have to select company, department and account. This is how we have to select the code combination. If you want to create any code combination in the system, we have to enable one checkbox called as allow dynamic inserts at structure level. That already we did in the last session. But we are not going to record the transactions now. Why we enabled it? Even you are not going to record the transactions now, you have to provide return earnings account in our primary ledger. Even if you are not going to record the transactions, you have to select the return earnings account in the primary ledger. When you are selecting the return earnings account, along with that, you should select company and department, since we have three segments. So if you want to provide the return earnings account in the primary ledger, we should enable the allow dynamic inserts at structure level. That means to create new code combinations. This is a new one combination we created. This is new. We never created this combination in the system. Okay. So if you are going to create one more code combination, say for example, the same, you're going to take 3000. Do you think to create this code combination, allow dynamic inserts need to be enabled? To create,
yes.
Now I'll go
and, yes.
Yeah, now I'll go and disable the allow dynamic inserts and I'll create the transaction with this code combination. System will accept or not? I'll go and
it
disable.
Will accept. It will accept.
Why?
It will not accept.
Somebody said it will accept. My question is why?
Because already the code combination created.
Yeah, that point is very, very important. Yes, that's what we have to understand. Allow dynamic inserts only for new code combinations, not for existing. Say we created this code combination and we created this code combination. So at the time of this two new code combinations, right? So we enabled allow dynamic insert, system is allowed, for example. Now you can go and disable allow dynamic inserts. If you are going to create it, system will accept. The reason is, this is not at all new code combination. Already that is created. Again, I'll go and create this code combination. Again, say structure level allow dynamic inserts are disabled. Will system accept?
Yes.
Yes. Because this also existing only, right? Now, yes. I'll go and disable allow dynamic inserts at chart of account level. I'll create this code combination. I'll try to create this code combination. What happens? System will allow.
It will not allow.
It won't allow.
It will verify any code combination, the same code combinations already available or not. No. Okay. If it is no, what system will do? It will verify. Allow dynamic inserts checkbox is enabled for this chart of accounts or not, it will verify. If it is enabled, it will allow. If it is not enabled, it won't allow. The first point it will verify, the whatever the code combination user is entering, that is new or existing. Okay. System identified as a existing, it will allow. System identified as not existing code combination, then it will verify allow dynamic inserts are enabled for the chart of accounts or not. From which chart of accounts you are using these codes, that chart of account level, allow dynamic inserts are enabled or not, it will verify. It's enabled, allows. It is not, that code combination, that combination is not at all existed, and chart of account structure level, allow dynamic inserts are not enabled, it won't allow you to select this combination to create the transactions or to specify this combination anywhere within the application. So this point we have to understand. Okay, fine. So now chart of account structure level, we enabled allow dynamic inserts. That's what we did in the last session, right? So now
that's not a question.
Please.
So for example, in a real scenario, like life scenario, if the requirement is not to enable the dynamic insertion, how would we do the code combinations then?
Okay. So in that case, what we'll do is, So what are the common normal code combinations they'll be using throughout the organizations or departments? All they'll be creating in one window. There is one window called as code combinations window. Okay, they enable for to enter in that also you have to enable allow dynamic insert checkbox. We'll enable allow dynamic inserts and we'll go and enter all the possible code combinations which we use in our company. After entering all the code combinations in that window, you will go and disable allow dynamic inserts. From that time onwards, if any user is going to record the business transactions, they can select existing code combinations only. New code combinations system won't allow.
And that would have to be done manually, like one at a time, right?
Yeah,
like
one. All the code combinations one time you have to create, then disable it.
Okay.
Okay. That's how you can do if you want to restrict all the time.
Okay.
So normally we don't disable. We'll keep open only. In the GL, we have some other security rules, cross validation rules. Through that, you can manage. Primarily cross validation rules we have, where you can set the rules saying that for this company this department is wrong department, for this company and this department combination source account is wrong. These all rules you can build. We'll see that as a part of GL, but your question is very much valid. In that case, this is how we manage. We'll enable allow dynamic inserts. The so-and-so super user or manager or somebody who is looking after all these account code combinations in the company, they will enter all these into separate window and they will disable the allow dynamic inserts. Then if any user is going to record the business transaction, they can enter the code combinations which are already predefined. Any new code combination, okay, they cannot. Still they want to enter, just go and enable allow dynamic inserts, then it will allow.
All right, got it. Thank you.
Yeah, thanks. Okay, done. So we enabled. Now we enabled not to record the transaction. We have to provide the retained earnings account. Retained earning account also, just account we cannot provide. Only account we cannot provide. Along with account, what are the other segments we have? Those segment values also we have to provide. Okay, that is the reason. Okay, that is the reason we enabled. Okay, we'll go to instance and we will provide retained earnings account in our primary ledger. Okay, wait 1 second. I think okay, just 1 second, please. Fine, just log into the instance.
Lakshman, one question.
Yep.
Yesterday you said that retained earnings comes under owner's equity. Why not comes under a revenue?
It's not a revenue for the company, right? So
means revenue, earnings may. One second.
Through revenue, you can make the profit, right? So that is a liable to the company point of view, it's a liability. Company point of view, you'll take, when you are creating the balance sheet, which side you will take it? Asset side or liability side? You'll take liability side. If you treat company organization as one entity, okay, it is liability for entity. It's not at all revenue. You should not take as a revenue. You can make the profit out of your revenues and all, but retained earnings. Okay, the profitability. How you get retained earnings? Revenue minus expense. Revenue is the revenue, but you are reducing expense. Then finally, that is your profit. So after distributing the profit or before, after distributing that, whatever the stakeholders, share and all, whatever you will be holding in the company account as a profit for the organization, that we are calling as retained earnings, not before reducing the expense, removing the expense and something else. That is always ownership account. Okay, you can Google it if you want to understand more than that. But what we have to understand is that is a point. Fine. Now, what we have to do? We have to go to responsibility, general ledger, vision, operations. Expand it. Expand journals. Click on enter. So I want to go to my primary ledger. What is the navigation?
Setup financials, accounting setup manager, accounting setup.
Voice is very low. What is the navigation to go to primary ledger? Anyone please?
Setup financials. Accounting setup manager, accounting setups.
That's all. Okay. So setup, financials, accounting setup manager, accounting setups. Before we go with this navigation, okay, we'll go and do verify whether we enabled allow dynamic inserts at our chart of account structure level or not. Yes, we enabled, but we'll go and review it. Since we are going to perform the relevant task, we'll verify once again. Okay. To navigate to chart of accounts, navigation to go to chart of accounts, navigation is setup, financials, flex fields, key segments. We know this navigation very well. We just navigated multiple times. And how to find out our chart of accounts? Click on find. Okay, we have to look for general ledger type G, it will filter. And within the general ledger, which flex field? Accounting flex field. The first combination you have to select and say okay. And here we have many chart of account structures within the accounting flex field. Since this is a visual instance, you can see these many. When you are working for your client, there won't be any chart of account. Whatever you create, that would be the first chart of accounts. Okay, so just place the cursor here to find out our chart of accounts. Click on search. So we given the name as Apple. So this is the one which we created, Apple accounting flex field. Select. So when you select this here, you can see allow dynamic inserts are enabled for this chart of account. That means within the chart of account, what are the segments we have, those segment values you can select and you can create the new code combination. Across these segments, you can select the segment values and you can create the new code combinations. That is the meaning of it. Done. So this is already enabled. So that system will allow us to create the new code combinations. Done. Now we'll go to primary ledger. Okay. Now we'll go to primary ledger and we'll provide this retained earnings account. Navigation is setup, financials, ASM, accounting setup manager, and accounting setups. First, we have to find our primary ledger. What are the primary ledger we created? That primary ledger we have to find. How to find? Once you land in this ASM home page, in this page, here we have a search section. So, search by ledger name. What is our ledger name? Apple India primary ledger. Okay, just click on, you don't need to type the full name, just click on go. It will display the ledger which we created, Apple India primary ledger. What is the status of our ledger? In progress. Okay, so finally we have to make it as a completed. Still we have time to do it. Before that we have to perform some other activities. Okay, done. So now within this primary ledger, we have to provide the retained earnings account, which is a mandatory compulsory account within every primary ledger. So to provide the retained earnings account for our primary ledger, click on update accounting options. Okay, so it's opening this page. So here, this is our primary ledger name. Under that, we have ledger options. So against the ledger options, click on update. Against the ledger options, click on update. Okay, against the ledger options, click on update. Fine. So within this page, we just gone through that information, the short name, how system created, we cannot change the currency, chart of accounts, accounting method. Only we can change the accounting method. Those points already we discussed. Okay, so click on next. So here we can see the field called as returned earnings. When you calculate your returned earnings, the end of the year, right? So that is the reason the section name they given as year end process. So you can go to search. Okay, here directly you can click on search. Click on go, it will display all the companies. I am selecting this company. We have four companies. I am selecting only one company. What about other companies? We'll discuss now itself. I'm selecting department. I'm selecting 1000. We have five departments. I'm selecting only one department. And which account we have to select here? Returned earnings. Select returned earnings account. So when you select the returned earnings account here, system will verify. When you create this returned earnings account, whether you are providing the account type as ownership or not. It will verify. Say you have given this account type as expense. It won't allow you to select this account. It will give the message. Okay, it will give you the message. That is the reason you have to select the right account type. I am selecting the account as returned earnings account. I selected primary ledger level. I selected one company, one department and returned earnings account. Reality, we no need to select company and department here. Account is enough. The system will calculate the returned earnings based on the transactions which are available, not based on which company and which department is available here. You will perform the transaction for company 1000, 2000, 3000, 4000 and based on those transactions in the year ending, system will calculate the returned earnings for each company. So here any one of the company you can choose. Any company, any department you can choose, but make sure that you are selecting the right account called as retained earnings account. Okay, doesn't matter which company, which departments you are taking here. Only the matter is for which companies you have a transactions. For those companies only system will calculate the retained earnings account. Just you say you may give the company 1000 here. If you are not going to have a transaction for a company called as 1000, system cannot calculate the retained earnings. So just you have to provide any one of the company and department here since the fields are mandatory. The star marks represents mandatory field. Company department accounts are mandatory, but primarily account only mandatory here since these three segments we are using, any one of the segment value you have to provide for company and department. But select account as a returned earnings account. The same account it will use for all the companies to calculate the returned earnings account. In the year ending process, it will display for so and so company 1, how much returned earnings, company 2, 3, 4, this is how it will display. Okay, please make a note of this point. You don't need to think we are not giving returned earnings account for company 2000, 3000, 4000. Okay, that is not at all required. Any one of the company department you can provide, this company, this department, company is not at all going to use to calculate this returned earnings account. Only the logic is, for which companies transactions are there, for all those companies it will calculate the returned earnings. That's all. Okay, we given this. Now here we have one tab called as create. If I click on create, what system will do is it will verify company 1000, department 1000, account 3000. With these three codes, any code combination is available or not in the system, it will verify. If it is available, it will display. In that case, if it is available, it will display if you click on search also. If you click on search, if the code combination is available, it will display. It is not displaying means this combination is not there in the system. Now if I click on create, when I create also it will verify whether the combinations exist or not. If it is not available, to create this new code combination, it will verify chart of account structure level allow dynamic insert checkbox is enabled or not. If it is not available, the code combination is not available and the allow dynamic insert checkbox is enabled at structure level, it will create the new code combination. Here it will create the code combination. It will display the new code combination what system will create here. Now no information here, right? No results found. So just click on create. Since we enabled allow dynamic inserts checkbox at chart of account structure level, now system will allow us to create the new code combination. Just click on create. Created. See? By taking these three segment values, system created new code combination. This is a new code combination. Okay. Select. Say select. This combination will be selected into this field. This is what we have to set up. Okay. So rest of many features we have in this as a part of ledger level and general ledger within the GL. When we are working on the GL, we'll just talk about the relevant features and what need to be enabled, what information we have to provide, what is the meaning of it, where we can use, how that would be useful, all we'll discuss. For now, the target is primary ledger creation. So to create the primary ledger, we given the required information, we have to provide the retained earnings account also. That's what we did. Okay, now you can click on next. You don't need to give any information in this stage, not required. When you are learning, when you are working for a client, you will be doing, but as a part of our course learning, you will come to know all those. Okay, for now, this is enough. Just click on next. So all the information system is displaying what we provided as a part of our primary ledger. Okay, so this is the name we give it. This is the currency, this is chart of account, this is the accounting calendar, and what is the accounting method, standard accruals, and retained earnings account, yes, we given, this is the code combination we given, all the information system is displaying, now you can say finish. That means we provided retained earnings account at primary ledger level by clicking on this update only. Now see that name got changed to our primary ledger name. Earlier the name was ledger options. Now we address the ledger is belongs to so and so. I mean, we given that accounting code combination, so system identified the ledger name here. Okay, just notice this point. Done. Okay, how many companies we have? How many companies we created here?
Companies.
Four companies, right?
Yes.
Yeah, four companies we created. Four companies we created. Those are 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, and 4,000. We given the name as Apple Computers, right? Apple Services, Apple BPO, Apple MacBook. These are the names we given. Those names can be anything. Just we have to identify how many companies we have. Okay, four companies we have. Then the code we given as 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000. So now say the organization has four companies. Say they are doing the business in India. Okay, they are doing the business in India and they have four companies. If any organization is running four companies, okay, companies means here we are taking, it could be branches or vertical of businesses. Okay, anything. So if one company is running the business in one country, how many registrations are required? Any one place? Your voice is very, very low. I cannot understand. I cannot hear, first of all. And one more point here. If somebody just gone through the videos or attended the previous batch, and again if they are attending, my request is don't answer to my questions. Okay, my questions always the people who are attending first time. Fine, now you can go ahead, but your voice is very low. I cannot hear you properly. Okay, it's somewhere.
Yeah. Lakshman, I think.
Please. How many registrations are required to run the business in one country? There could be n number of verticals.
Only one registration is required.
Can we have separate registration for four companies? Organization is only one.
No.
Any other answers?
Yes.
Any other answers?
If you are doing different businesses like electronics or import or export business, like if that in that case we need different registrations.
Yes. So by default, for one enterprise, one organization, let the organization do multiple businesses, one registration would be enough. In that, the companies of the memorandum what they submit to the Companies Act, within that they can include what are the activities, what are the businesses they are doing. That means in one country, one registration is enough. But if they want to have a separate registrations, yes, possible. They can go with a separate registrations. They are running the four businesses. The enterprise is only one. Take example, Tata. They have multiple vertical of businesses. TCS, Tata Consulting Services, Tata Telecommunications. These are the different verticals. All comes under one group of company. So they can have one registration, but reality they have a separate registrations. Since those are very large, large volume of the transactions and large organizations, they are just doing the business. Based on that, they can plan and they can do it. If any organization doing the different vertical of businesses, if they want to have one registration for multiple businesses, we can just do it. Or else if they want to go with a separate registration for each vertical of business, that is also possible. But normally, most of the companies will go with a single registration. Otherwise, if they want to decentralize their process and other regulations and everything separate, then only they can go. That too, very big companies only do in that way. Okay, small and medium sized companies, normally they go with a common registration only. Okay, in this case, since business is in one country, for four businesses, they can have one registration. Okay, four companies, we can have one registration. So whatever the registration they have to run these four companies, that we have to enter in the system. I am taking simple example. Okay, say for example, to run the company 1000 and 2000, they have registration 1. Okay, registration 1. And to run the companies like 3000 and 4000. Okay, I am not taking the current example which we are doing. You can take just any one of the examples. Say four companies are there. The four companies belongs to different. These two related to some software, IT related, maybe consulting services and other IT enabled services. These are two are related to different vertical of businesses. But they want to have a common registration for these two companies. And say they have a separate registration for 3000 and 4000. Registration 2, yes. They are running the business in one country. How many companies they are running? Four companies. And for first two companies, one registration. Okay, first two companies, they have one registration. And three and four companies, they have a different registration. So these two companies, they are running under which registration? Registration 1. Okay, is under registration 1, okay, separate registration they are running, and these 3000, 4000, these two companies are running with this registration. That means as per this company 1000, 2000 related business transactions and the reports, the legal reporting and all, they will be submitting to by following this registration number. For these companies, when we register, we'll have a registration number by following that. and we'll have a complete taxation and separately for these two companies. And these 3,000, 4,000, they have a separate registration, and accordingly they'll be doing the reporting to government. Okay, so that's how we have. So now this company is up, has four this organization has four companies, and for first two companies one registration, remaining two companies separate registration. So now totally they got two registrations. The two registrations, however, we are going to maintain these four companies information in our application. We created as a companies, right? In the same way, this registration information also we have to maintain in the system. The registration information also we have to maintain. When we go for registration, we have to provide the address. What is the physical office address? Or you can say head office address you may provide for registration. Right? So you'll be providing by providing the address where physically you are just based out. Okay, we'll go for registration. So that's how say we have a two registrations. Now these two registrations we have to bring into the system with the concept called as legal entity. Company registration information we have to maintain in the system as a legal entity. So how many registrations we have? Two registrations. That means how many legal entities we have to create? Two legal entities. So registration information will track into system as a legal entity. Okay, that registration means legal identification. Okay, legal identification. The company will have a just entitlement to run the business. Legal entity. So registration one means I am writing as a legal entity one. The second registration, legal entity two. Fine. Where we have these companies? Where we have all these companies? Anyone, please? Sorry?
Ledger. Primary ledger.
We have these companies within the primary ledger. Okay, we have these companies within the primary ledger. Right, we have in the primary ledger. How we have in the primary ledger? Within the primary ledger, we have chart of accounts. Within the chart of account, we have a segment called as company. To that segment, we assign company value set. That's how we have these companies within the primary ledger. Fine. So we have these four companies within the primary ledger. Not only companies, department and account values also we have in the primary ledger only. Okay, done. So these four companies, I don't want to call as company segment values. I want to call with some different name. How I can call? These are company values only. I don't want to call as a company values. I want to call with some other name. What is the best name you can use?
Segment one.
Sorry?
Segment one.
No, no, no.
Legal entities?
No, how you can call the companies as a legal entity? Lot of background noise from your end. See, I have a segment called as company. I don't want to call this segment as a company segment. I want to call with a different name. What is the name?
Business.
Sorry?
Business.
Anyone, please. Already we discussed.
Balancing segment.
That's it. That's it. Balancing segment. Segment, because we are assigning balancing segment flexible qualifier. So based on that qualifier assignment, the company segment you can call as balancing segment. So under company, if you have a segment values, you call as a company segment values, right? Under company, if you are going to have the values, those you call as company segment values.
Company.
Now company, you are not calling as a company, you are calling as a balancing segment.
Balancing.
Now these values you can call as, instead of calling as a company values, you can call as
balancing segment values.
That's all. We'll call it as balancing segment values. One request is, if you have background noise, please don't unmute. Okay, these all we call as balancing segment values, BSVs. Okay, so balancing segment values. Now we'll take the same term directly. Now within the primary ledger, we have balancing segment values. So the first two balancing segment values are belongs to registration one. The remaining two belongs to registration two. Now we'll remove these terms called as registration, because we understand, we already discussed and understood about what is a legal entity. Now what we have to do? What we have to do is, we have to specify these two balancing segment values. That means these two companies we are running under which registration. So that means we have to specify these two are under this and these two are under this. Okay, that's how we have to specify. If you want to specify these two are under legal entity 1, these two are under legal entity 2. Legal entity simply we call as LE. Okay, here you can say LE1 and LE2. So we have to specify these four companies we are running under which registration. These two under this registration, these two are under this registration. Now if you want to specify these two companies we are running under this registration and these two are under this registration, what we have to do is, first you have to connect the legal entity to this primary ledger. So how many companies we have? Four companies. The four companies we are running under which registration? Two registration. So first of all, what we have to do is, you have to assign these legal entities to primary ledger. That is the first point. Okay. Legal entity is nothing but registration. How many registrations the organization has, those many legal entities we have to create in the system. Just now we discussed, to run these four companies, they have two registrations. Now the first point what we have to do is, we have to create these two legal entities. So create legal entity. How many legal entities, how many registrations company has, those many legal entities we have to create. Create legal entity, LE. LE means legal entity. How many registrations we have, those many legal entities we have to create. After that, what we have to do is, so if you want to assign these two balancing segment values to LE1, this two to LE2, directly you cannot do. First, what we have to do is, you have to assign legal entities to primary ledger, then some relation will be built. Then you can assign these balancing segment values to legal entity. So first you have to create, okay, one or two, how many you have, you can create. After that, what we have to do? You have to assign how many legal entities you have in a specific country. Those all legal entities you have to assign to your primary ledger. You have two legal entities. Two legal entities you have to assign to your primary ledger. That is the second step. First, you have to create how many legal entities you have. After that, you have to assign legal entities to your primary ledger. Okay, assign legal entities to primary ledger. Done. Why we are assigning the legal entities to primary ledger? Our requirement is, we want to assign the balancing segment values to legal entities. If you want to assign these two balance and segment values to this legal entity without assigning the legal entity to primary ledger, the whatever the balance and segment values we have in this primary ledger, those cannot be assigned to legal entity. That is the reason. Okay, our requirement is we have to specify these companies we are running with which registration. Directly you cannot do. You have to assign the legal entity first to primary ledger, then you can assign this. After that, the company 1000 and 2000 we are running with which registration? LE1, right? Now you have to assign the company, the balance and segment value to balance and segment value 1000 to LE1, and balance and segment value 2000 also you are running under the same registration, assigned to the same legal entity. Done. The same way you have to assign balance and segment value 3000 to LE2 and 4 also to LE2. That's it. Okay, next step is we have to assign balancing segment values. Which segment values are balancing segment values? Anyone, please. Simple question. Which segment values are balancing segment values?
These are all the segments.
Company. Any other answers?
Which are all the segments? The balancing segment is enabled. Those are all called balancing segment values.
Correct. That is no doubt that is correct. But simple way you can say which segment values are balancing segment values. Simply you can say balancing segment values are balancing segment values. Right? Balancing segment values are balancing segment values. Which is the balancing segment means you can say that point. To which segment we are assigning the balancing segment flex field qualifier, that segment is balancing. Which segment values are balancing segment values means which segment values? Balancing segment values. Which segment is balancing segment? To which segment we are assigning balancing segment flex field qualifier, that segment is balancing. Okay, this is how just we have to present. Done. So we have to assign balance and segment values to what we want to, we have to assign to legal entities. Okay, this is how we have to do it. Hope it is clear to everyone. Now in our case, instead of creating 2-3 legal entities, we'll go with one legal entity. So in that case, what we do, if you know how to create one legal entity, you can create second one. So now what we'll do is, we'll go with one legal entity. Okay, here we can give the name as Apple India legal entity. And we have four companies, we'll assign those four to, we'll assign that legal entity to our primary ledger and the four balance and segment values to same legal entity. That means we are running the four companies under same registration. That is the meaning of it. Okay, after completing this, first we have to create the legal entity. The second step is we have to assign the legal entity to primary ledger. Assign legal entity to primary ledger. How many legal entities we have, those many we have to assign. The next step. We have to assign the balance and segment values to legal entity. To which primary ledger we assigned our legal entity, within that primary ledger how many balance and segment values we have, those we have to assign to our legal entity. After completing this, you can complete the ledger creation. You have to complete primary ledger. Okay, just if it's just creation, you can say. Okay, you can complete primary ledger creation. What is the meaning of it? If you complete the primary ledger creation, then only you can use that primary ledger. Creation, completing the primary ledger creation means system has to display primary ledger status as a completed. We'll see that point, how that would be represented in the system. But try to understand. This is what we have to do now. We are ready with the primary ledger. We are ready with the primary ledger. But within the primary ledger, what are the four companies we have? Those need to be addressed. Those need to be specified with a registration information. The company registration information in our application we create as a legal entity. So after creating legal entity, that need to be assigned to primary ledger. Within the primary ledger, what are the balance and segment values we have, which we are running by following that registration, we have to associate with the same registration information, nothing but legal entity information. Then finally, we have to complete the primary ledger. That means we have companies, departments, accounts, which are associated with the legal entities. Then you can record the transactions. And before recording, what else we have to do, we'll discuss and do it. Hope these points are clear to everyone. How to complete, that we'll see in the system. Okay, what is the meaning of completion also, we'll discuss. So any points, any questions here to understand these points, please. No questions. Now we'll go and create the legal entity. We'll go and create the legal entity. So in the same window, under accounting setup, just we are here, right? Once you take this navigation, double click, we are landing in this page. So from here, by clicking on create accounting setup and all, we created our primary ledger. Now we want to create the legal entity. Okay, now we want to create the legal entity. If you want to create the legal entity, here we have a tab, legal entities. You can go to this tab and you can create the legal entity. If not from here, from here also you can create the legal entity from first tab, but directly you cannot see anything. Click on create accounting setup. Here we have create legal entity. So to create the primary ledger, what we did, we clicked on next and system allowed to create the primary ledger, right? This is how we created primary ledger. So if you want to create legal entity, just click on create legal entities tab. Here you can find out existing legal entity. This is search area. Okay, by default you can just, legal entities are specific to countries. Okay, so within one country you may have multiple legal entities also, but the specification with the country. Fine. Now we didn't create any legal entities. What are the legal entities already created in this environment? Ignore it, and we'll go and create our own legal entity. Okay, here we have a tab called as create legal entity. Just click on this. Just click on create legal entity. So territory, nothing but country. Okay, territory, nothing but country. Here India. Why India is coming? How system knows? We have one profile option. If you set that profile option within the application, wherever you go, that country will be displayed. I'll show you how to set which is the profile option. But as of now, simple point is, system is selecting India. If system is not selecting India, if system is selecting some other country, we will be selecting which country we require. The legal entity belongs to which country, that country we have to select by clicking on search. Okay, this is how we have to select. Now we have to write our legal entity name, nothing but registration name. So when we are working for any client, client will provide the document, registration document. Okay, from that you can get all the legal identification number, their PAN number, all the details. You can get the genuine information will be entering here. Now we are trying to understand. You can enter any test here, system will accept. So legal entity name. Legal entity name is Apple India legal entity. What is the actual organization name? Say organization name is Apple India Private Limited. That means registration name, registered name. legal entity identifier. When you go with the registration, in the registration process, you will get some identification number for the company. That registration company identification number you have to enter. Here you can enter any number, system will accept. The company PAN number you can enter, no validation, it could be more than 10 digits also, it will accept. And this IEC and EIC, just in case of companies into imports and exports business, that number you can specify here, otherwise not required. Transaction entity, yes, this is a, if it is a real registration information, you can set to, it should be yes only. Some internal purpose, some dummy definitions, if you are creating, you can set to no. So this is actual registration of company, so it should be yes only. Now here, legal address, we have two options. Select existing address or else create new address. What is the address? When you go for registration, we'll provide some address to the address for the registration, that is the physical office address, or that may be head office or corporate office address. So whatever we address is presented in our registration documents, that address we have to provide here. So we can go with create new address. Select create new address. So here system is, the format is missing. That is the reason location it is showing here, other fields it is showing here. Okay, some format is missing. Maybe browser issue, no. No, by default in this instance, the format is missing. Otherwise all should be in the sequence, no issues. So location name you can enter. See, this is a vision instance. Already many locations are created in this. If you are going to give the location as, say, for example, Hyderabad, there may be a number of locations with Hyderabad. System will identify that as a duplication and all. So that is the reason when you are creating the location here, you can just give the name as Apple Hyderabad. Otherwise, just you have to enter location identification as a Hyderabad only. Okay. So here you can provide as per registration document, whatever the address we have, that you can enter here. The building name, say ABC building or Apple building. Okay, all the information you can see, the which fields are mandatory, which fields are optional. Here star mark, that means it's a mandatory field, and these all building name, road, street, etc., area, all these are optional fields. If you want to enter the test, you can enter, otherwise ignore it. Okay, enter city name. Okay, other state, pin code and all. Reality, when you are creating, yes, we'll be providing all this. Now it's not required, just optional fields, you can ignore it. Okay, and here general information. See, the total information is classified into three parts. One is identification information, with this company will be identified. Address, where company is located, and general information. Okay, so place of registration, where we did the registration, and business activity, what company do, and sub business activity, type of company, some corporation, or those specifications you can give. Type of company, these are the values available, you can limited company or etc., etc., you can specify. So this is how, if you want to provide this information, you can provide. Otherwise, at least provide currency. Currency is INR. Type IN, it will display. You can select this. Somebody created currencies, please, you don't create. There is no meaning in that. So Oracle is providing, you have to use it. You cannot have your own currencies. Okay, INR. We given this information. Now, you can click on apply, then system has to save this legal entity information. So reality, when we are working for our client, if you provide the information like this, you'll be able to save it. But in this instance, there are two chances. The one chance is system will accept to save. The other case is it may give you some error message. When system will give the error message, if the location information, too many locations are available with the relevant information, it may just throw some error message. So if you see that any error message when you are practicing, just change the names or else change these numbers, etc. there may be some definitions which are similar to these naming conventions, or there may be some number who somebody entered with the same number, or etc. Same naming convention. There may be, there are chances where the 100% or 80% or 90% the records are duplicating. In that case, system will give the error message. Since this is a vision instance which you are using practice, many people will go with a similar data most of the times. Okay, company may be name may be different, location is similar, it gives some error message. So when you are practicing, if you see any error message, just change the data and it will accept. When you are working for your client, you won't face this kind of issues. Reason, there won't be any sample data, there won't be any other definitions will be created by someone else. You will be the one to create all these. Okay, so that is a point we have to understand. Now we will see how system is going to respond. Just click on apply. If system is going to give any error message, we'll just change the data, it will accept. If it is going to accept, okay, cool. But we have to understand the point. Okay, it's accepted. That means there is no too much of similarity or data record, okay, in the database. So it is accepted. So system created. You have successfully created new legal entity called as Apple India Legal Entity. Done. We created. What is the next step? What is the next step?
Assign this one to balancing segment.
What is the next step? That is the reason I am just telling, please make a note of each and every point so that any question you can see and you can answer at least.
Assign legal entity to your primary ledger.
Assign legal entity to primary ledger, right? I just clearly explained and written. Still answers are wrong. Okay, fine. We created legal entity. Now we have to assign the legal entity to primary ledger. Fine, we'll go and do it. So how to do it? It's very simple. Go to accounting setups. Go to accounting setups. So we want to assign legal entity to our primary ledger, right? So first we have to find the primary ledger. To which primary ledger we want to assign this legal entity? Find that primary ledger. We have only one. Find here. Apple India primary ledger. Just click on go. Okay. So here click on update accounting options. Okay, click on update accounting options. It will open the page. Here you can see one tab called as add legal entity. They given the tab name as add legal entity. Reality, the process wise, we have to consider this as a assigning legal entity. Okay, to assign the legal entity to this primary ledger, or here also we have title. To assign our legal entity to this primary ledger, we have to click on add legal entity. Okay, what we are doing? To which primary ledger we want to assign our legal entity, we have to find that primary ledger. Type the name, click on go. Click on update accounting options. Click on the pencil icon. Now we'll be landing in this page. So we want to assign our primary ledger to this. We want to assign our legal entity to this primary ledger. Right? So to assign the legal entity to this primary ledger, click on add legal entity. Okay. Again, we have a tab called as add legal entity. Click on that. Okay. Now search for our legal entity. Click on go. So select and click on select. Remember, one legal entity you can assign to only one primary ledger. Okay, one legal entity we can assign to only one primary ledger. Now after assigning, again if you search you cannot find. That means one legal entity you can assign to only one primary ledger. Multiple legal entities can be assigned to one primary ledger. That point we discussed. Yeah, please.
Can we unassign primary ledger to a legal entity?
Can we unassign primary ledger to legal entity? We never assign primary ledger to legal entity to primary ledger.
Okay, so can we unassign legal entity to primary ledger?
Yeah, before you complete your primary ledger, you can do it. Once you complete the primary ledger, we'll start using. So system won't allow. That point also we are going to see. Now system will give the message also to us.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, before completing, you can do it. Once you complete, you cannot. Fine. Select and say select. That would be selected here. The selection you have to confirm by clicking on apply. See here. Now, can you remove the legal entity which you are assigning to your primary ledger? This is your primary ledger, right? For Apple India primary ledger, we are assigning the legal entity. Can we remove this assigned legal entity we assigned now? Can we remove? Yes.
Yes.
Remove.
Yes.
There, that too not grayed out, right? It is active.
Yes.
Now, we'll say apply. See what system says. Okay, and just once, just we have to complete at that time. Just it'll throw the error message. We'll see that. We assigned one legal entity. See here, legal entity is available. If you have one more legal entity to assign to this primary ledger, same process. Go to add legal entity. Click on add legal entity and search for legal entity. I'm typing A if any legal entity is available, which is not at all assigned to any primary ledger, that will system will display. We'll see that. Yes, there is one legal entity called as AP3 India legal entity. This is not at all assigned to any primary ledger, that is the system is display. This is how you can assign, but anyway, we don't need it. So cancel to go back. So we assigned this primary ledger, this legal entity to this primary ledger. Now what is the next step?
Assign balancing segment values to legal entity.
So within this primary ledger, what are the balance and segment values we have? Those you have to assign to this legal entity. How to assign? It's very simple. The task which you are going to perform is assign balance and segment values to legal entity. To which legal entity you want to assign to this legal entity? So against this legal entity, you have one option called as update balancing segment values. Update balancing segment values. You have one option. Just click on this. To assign the balancing segment values to this legal entity, just click on update. Click on update. So now here we have a tab called as add balancing segment value. System is automatically selecting company value set. Because company only we assign the balancing segment flex fuel qualifier. System can understand. Okay, which segment is balancing. That is the reason that segment value set only it is fetching here. So within this value set, how many values we have, that system will display if you click on add balancing segment values. Just click on add balancing segment values. Click on go. So four we have. So say to run this four companies, we have same registration. So you can assign these four companies to same legal entity. Select four, say select, or else instead of selecting one by one here, you have option to select all also. Click on select all will get selected, then say select. Now earlier what we did before this step, primary ledger, sorry, legal entity we assigned to primary ledger, right? Legal entity we assigned to primary ledger. Now what we are doing? Balance and segment values we are assigning to legal entity. Now, can we unassign these balance and segment values to our legal entity? Here we have option to remove. Yes, we can do it. But once we complete the primary ledger, you cannot remove this. That means once we complete the primary ledger, you cannot undo these two tasks. That message also will get, we'll see that. Fine, we assigned. Okay. So now say apply. Now you can see as assigned. See here, you can see those four balance and segment value 1000, 2000, 3000, 4000. So from where we assign these, those are there within the primary ledger. You say this name or this name, you can point. So within this primary ledger, we have four balance and segment values. Those we assign to legal entity, where you can see which you assign here. Balance and segment values, you can see, done. What is the next step? We have to complete the primary ledger. So after completing all these activities, you have to complete your primary ledger. So what is the status of our primary ledger? We'll go and see. Go to accounting setups. This is our primary ledger name. Click on go. What is the status? In progress. If primary ledger status is in progress, you cannot use it. The status should be completed. This tick mark should be completed, then only this primary ledger we can use. Okay, just click on update. So here only we assign this legal entity to this primary ledger, and within this primary ledger, what are the balance and segment values are available, those we assign to this legal entity, the same you can see from here. Now system will allow you to remove the legal entity which you assign to this primary ledger. And if you go to this update option, system will allow you to remove the balance and segment values which you assign to legal entity. These two system will accept. It will accept till you go and complete the ledger definition. Fine. Now here we have one tab. See here. Complete. Just click on complete. Now see the message. You are about to complete your primary ledger called Apple India Primary Ledger. This will save your setup options and prevent. It will prevent deletion of certain components. Which components? Legal entities. The legal entities which you assign to your primary ledger, those you cannot delete. You cannot remove. And balance and segment values. The balance and segment values which you assign to legal entity, those you cannot delete. Now you can see here, remove legal entity option. Once you complete, this would be grayed out. In the same way, balance and segment values. Reporting currency is separate future. When you are working on GL, you will understand that. Okay, but notice as message, it is including that. Okay, do you want to proceed? Yes. Say yes. Now system will complete and it will freeze this removing of the legal entity and other points. So it's just you complete it. Click on return to accounting setup. It will take us to this accounting setup home page. Just click on this. Now see the status of your ledger. What is the status? Completed. The status indication for completed. Now click on update. Can we remove your legal entity? There is no option to remove. You cannot remove it. Earlier here we got remove legal entity option. Now it is not available because you completed your primary ledger. After completing, you cannot remove. Go to update balance and segment values. The remove option is grayed out. You cannot do anything. So you are running the business. After some time, you are not going to record the business. You stop complete business as a, say for example, Apple services. You stopped. So in that case, you cannot remove. So what you can do is, here you can give the end date for this balance and segment value so that this value won't be displayed when you are recording the transactions. That's how you can give the end date. You cannot remove, but you can give end date. When you talk about primary legal entity, you cannot do anything with that. So now our primary ledger is ready with the status called as completed. Okay. So now after primary ledger, what we have to do? We discussed in the previous sessions. So our primary ledger is ready. Say primary ledger is ready. Or else let me write here so that here I can list out the points. Primary ledger is ready. Now what we have to do? Anyone please. We discussed the
create organization.
No, we have to create the responsibility.
Responsibility.
Okay. You can take any one of the application just for understanding. I am taking GL. So GL responsibility. Can we use the primary ledger directly in the responsibility? We discussed all these points. I have primary ledger and responsibility ready. Can I use?
We need to assign that to primary ledger to responsibility.
Responsibility. How to assign?
By using profile option.
By using profile option. By using which profile option?
GL ledger name.
That is a profile option name. Okay. Now we have to assign. Okay. This primary ledger to. Okay. This primary ledger to. Okay. GL. Responsibility. How to assign? How to assign? By using profile option called as GL ledger name. What is the GL ledger name? That is a profile option name. The profile option name is GL ledger name. By using GL ledger name profile option, we can assign primary ledger to responsibility. Okay. Then what is the next step? We discussed all these points. Now this responsibility how to assign to?
User.
Yes. Okay. Now the user can have access to this responsibility. When the user is going to record any business transaction within the responsibility, which primary ledger is already associated with that responsibility, by using that primary ledger, user can record the business transactions. Okay, these we'll see in the tomorrow session. Okay, so we are ready with the primary ledger. When you say we are ready with the primary ledger, legal entity and everything is associated, that we no need to specify separately. When you say primary ledger thing, you have a legal entities, then this primary ledger will be holding the companies. So in the next session, we'll see how to create the responsibility, how to assign the primary ledger to responsibility by using GL ledger name profile option, then how to create the user, how to assign the GL responsibility to user, from that user, how to log into the instance, how to access this GL responsibility. So as of now, we are using one responsibility called as General Ledger Vision Operations USA. So instead of using that, we will access to GL responsibility. Whatever you can see from General Ledger Vision Operations USA responsibility, the everything you can find from the GL responsibility. When you are creating GL responsibility, we'll talk about what is the meaning of that definitions and all. Okay, so this is what we are going to do. So now we are ready with our primary ledger. Our primary ledger status is completed. So if the primary ledger status is in progress, you cannot assign that primary ledger to your responsibility. If primary ledger status is completed, then only you can assign that primary ledger to responsibility. So this is the point you have to understand. Any questions from today's session, please. So one thing is
Lakshman.
Yeah, please.
After completing the primary ledger, can we create legal entity and can we assign?
After creating, yes, you can do that. Normally, when you are creating, we'll be knowing how many legal entities we are going to create. That is the reason. After completing everything, we'll make it as complete. That is the meaning of completion, right?
After completion of primary ledger.
We can do that. We can do that. But reality, when you are creating, when you are implementing this, this is how we'll do. In future, they may start some new business. Right? They may have a separate registration.
Yes.
How many companies they have, those many companies will be adding into companies value set. Now we have four companies. They may come up with one more company called as 5,000. This may have separate registration. This 5,000 will be entering into company value set. Go and create one more legal entity. Assign that legal entity to the same primary ledger. Assign this balance and segment value to that legal entity. Done. Anytime you can do it. Anytime you can add new balance and segment value to your value set. Anytime you can create and assign the legal entity to your primary ledger. And you can associate balance and segment values to legal entities. Anytime you can do it. Since we are doing all as an initial setup, we followed that process which should be followed. Future, if you want to add something, anything, you can do that.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, any other questions?
Lakshman, when we are talking about the code combinations, you mentioned manually there is a form to create the code combinations, right? In normal practice, will companies do that?
No. They will allow. They
okay.
will allow. They'll set the rules. That will be understanding when we are working on GL. So in the GL, we have a rule called as CVR. Cross-validation rules. If I explain now, you won't get it. CVR, cross-validation rule. With this, you can set the conditions. Okay, we'll work on it. Okay, but as of now, to understand the code combination, that is a point.
Okay.
If some company want to disable, they can do it. That's their internal process, right?
But will they do it? Will they disable it after some time when they create all the combinations? Will they do it? Is it normal practice or?
No. Generally, very less clients go with that option, disabling. All the clients, what they do is they'll allow the users to create new code combination. Reason, every user knows very well what is their responsibility, what transaction they're recording and each and everything. So they'll leave it to users. Okay. So that's how they manage.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah, thank you. Fine. Any other questions here, please?
Lakshman, I checked with the team.
One second. Those points we'll discuss in the end of the session, please.
Okay.
About subject now, please. Yeah, we'll discuss. Anyway, that is also everything is important. Okay. We'll talk on that if you have any issue related to instance or etc. Any questions? Fine, no questions. So one thing is very important, you have to read and remember. If you are answering to my questions, you can think from your end you are in the very right track. If you are not able to answer to my questions, which are very basic questions, so you'll keep attending. If you are not going to answer, things will become difficult going forward. Okay, that's all from my side.